Hi guys, how are you doing? It's Nikki from Nikki Bartha Fitness. So today I would like to share with you a quick video regarding your glutes, your butt cheeks, okay? A little bit of anatomy just to understand it, okay? We're doing glutes exercises, not just to actually lift it up and then looking good. So normally when I'm calling it, please don't get offended, truck driver butt. So you know the truck driver butt is like nice and flat. It's coming from their job, completely fine, okay? If you start working on it, obviously start to lift up, getting nice and rounded and shapy. However, my main focus is to actually get your glutes nice and strong as well, because I call it as a lazy ass face. So if you do have a lazy butt, what does it mean? Every single time you do exercises, so such as squats, lunges, if you are into CrossFit and you do Olympic weightlifts such as clean and jerk, snatches and so on, your quads, your hip flexors tend to take over. However, your glute muscles are the biggest muscle group in your body. So if you have it nice and strong, you can actually avoid lower back pain, you can actually lift heavier, you can actually move better. Okay? So let's get down on the floor. You don't need anything else today, just yourself, maybe a mat if you want. So regarding that, we're going to start with hip ridges. So when you're lying down on your ground for your hip ridge position, what is really important, keeping the heels nice and close to your glutes, and your feet and your knees are hip width apart. Now, if you don't know what is hip width apart, completely fine, just check this with tips. From here, you're going to bring the feet together, obviously down on the ground. Open up your toes like pizza slices and then your heels with it. Okay? You can always come back, you can always use this option. That's your feet and knees are hip width apart. Now, once we establish this, from here, we're going to bring the hands next to the body, palms facing up, and tuck the shoulder blades under one at the same time. If you're a little bit tight and you let your arms out, completely fine. But I want to have your chest nice and open, because most of the time we are rounded. Okay, so make sure that you're nice and open with that chest. From here, how we start, we breathe in, as you breathe out, you squeeze your butt cheeks together, you're coming up into your hip ridge, inhale at the top, as you exhale, nice and slow, coming down. Inhale at the bottom, exhale to roll up. Inhale at the top, exhale to roll down. Now keep going with your breathing, okay? What I want you to focus on when you lift up, you're really squeezing the butt cheeks together to push your hips up to the ceiling. When you go down nice and slow through the spine, you squeeze butt cheeks together, and on the top, while you're holding, while you're breathing in, draw the tummy muscles to the belly, and then coming nice and slow down. Gonna go for another 5 reps, because we're just doing 10 in total. Now, what I want you to focus on, if you started to feel in the back of the legs, have that mind and muscle connection, draw your attention on these butt cheeks, squeezing these butt cheeks together as hard as you can, and then come in nice and slow down. Now make sure that you're pushing through the heels, but your big toes are not lifting up, okay? At the same time, keep opening that chest. I lost counting, so let's say 2 more. Okay, 2 more. Good, squeeze that glutes right on the top, and then 1 more. Now, on this last one, we're going to stay up and we hold. Now, as you up and hold, I want you to shift your weight to your right side. From here, we're going to lift up the left leg, nice and straight. Not dropping the hips, okay? So normally what's happening, as soon as we're doing a single leg version, you're dropping the hips down. Keep it up, 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 okay? You can keep your knee gently bending. From here, we're going to move. Breathe in, bringing the leg down. Breathe out, left. Inhale. Exhale, lift. Very focused, but you're not dropping the hips down, okay? Keep squeezing that right glute, you should be really on fire. And then left for me. Exhale, up. Come on, just
one more, which is saying six. I hope I counted six. Good. Release. Coming down. Reset your head back. Push it up. And then the opposite leg. Left up. Breathe in. Bring it down. Breathe out. Left up. Inhale. Bring it down. Breathe out. Left up. Going to go for another four more. Try to keep the body in line. So shoulder, hip, and knee in one line. Two more. I know, I'm not good with that, so. Now, this side for me is much harder. Now, bring the leg back. Reset your hip bridge, coming back to the first leg. Left. From here, inhale, coming down. Exhale to lift. Now, I feel this side, my right side, my glutes is stronger. So I definitely feel that burning sensation, and I definitely feel it's working. If you do feel your lower back, please take 5 to 10 seconds rest, okay? If it's a little burning sensation, completely fine. Now, back to the opposite side. On this side, I really need to focus on that glutes. It just doesn't want to work, guys. Honestly, it just doesn't want to work. And you see how I'm even dropping it down. So I'm really need to focus to keep pushing up, 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 up. Now let's go for two more. Focus on that breathing. Inhale. Exhale. Now we release. Bring the knees to your chest or side to side. Now. As I mentioned to you, if you didn't want, you should definitely feel the arches. You possibly feel in the back of the legs a little bit, completely fine, and the lower back a little bit. And it's always a burning sensation when you're looking for. So if you do feel a pinch, please stop straight ahead, okay? Pinching feeling, you're not looking, it's a lovely burning sensation. Anytime you need that 5-10 second rest, please do so. Next one, we're going to go for donkey kicks, one of our favorite. Now, donkey kicks is, you're standing up into all fours. Now, to go through on these all fours, I think it's really important. So your hands coming right under the shoulders. I always say, spread the fingers, because it's just going to give you a little bit of better stability. Let me come a little bit more forward. Cool. Now, from here, check your knees. It should be right under your hips. In line with the hands. So if I have that, that's my proper all fours. Not shrugging up, push the shoulders away from the ears. Not dropping the hips down, okay? Make sure that you're not grounding neither. Hips in line with the shoulders. How do you know that? Squeeze your glutes, draw the tummy muscles in. Now, once we have this, from here, the donkey kicks, you're going to shift your weight to one side. And we're going to lift up the opposite leg. Now, sometimes you might feel you need to bring the one leg into the middle. You can even put a pillow underneath your knees, completely fine, okay? So what we're looking is the stability to work on the stabilization muscles. That's why I would like you to keep the leg where it is. However, if you need to bring it into the middle, completely fine, okay? So from here, that one leg lift up. Looking, what's normally happen? We twist out. So find your hip bones. Make sure that your hip bones facing down to the ground. Okay? So once we have that, from here, heels pointing up to the ceiling, lock the tummy in, breathe in, breathe out, kick. Kick. Inhale down, exhale, kick. Little ones. Now make sure that we're not arching too much, okay? Keeping the abs nice and straight. And keeping the abs on. From here, I already feel my glutes, and we're gonna go for 50 little reps. Now, you keep going, for me, it's really hard to count and explain. But make sure you do 50. 5? Yeah, 50. Cool. So, drawing those tummy muscles to your belly button is really important. Make sure that your hips is not twisting side to side. Neither your upper body, okay? So it's really important that we're locking the whole body in, and then we're gonna go for these little ones. Let's say we're gonna go for 20 more. And then kicking with those heels, okay? So it's a heel. Imagine you're gonna make a hole on the top of your ceiling with little ones. Little ones. That's 10, 9, 8, 7. If you do it right, your butt should be on fire. 5, 4, 3. Now, without releasing, we're going to bring it down, not touching the ground. And this time, toes are pointing away and going to the side. Exhale, side, inhale, back. Exhale, side, inhale, back. Now, this one, again, what's normally happening? You're twisting out too much. So, we're not twisting your hips. Your hips are locked in. 50 reps again. Keep going. So, this one targeting not just the glutes, but your side hips area. Probably you feel your opposite side started to kick it in. Good. It's an isometric hold. That's how your glutes started to work. So does the legs. Okay? And as you're getting tired, it's better to take 5-10 seconds rest instead of starting to twist with your hips. Okay? You do it right. You should feel it right over here as well your glutes. Okay? So just little ones. Exhale out, inhaling. Exhale out, inhaling. Your range of motion is limited regarding your hip flexibility and mobility because we're not twisting that hips. Now, I'm not sure how much we've done, but let's go for another 20. You already done 50? Sure, stay with me, okay? We can do this together. Come on. Exhale. Try to lift it higher for that last 13, but without moving your hips, okay? And then nearer there, come on. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4. Now, you know you're gonna hate me, but me not resting yet, so watch this. Hold it out. Circling, big circles, but not twisting your hips, okay? Now, just 10 in one direction, 10 to the other direction. So we already got 5, 6, imagine you circling with your knees, 7, 8, 9, 10, wait for it, opposite direction, up to the side, back, not twisting the hips, okay? Imagine that we have a fan on the top of your knee, and that's how you're making these circles with your knees. Stay on this. I'm sure we got like just another 4 to go. 4, 3, 2, 1. There you go. Quickly put it back into that child pose. Give yourself a bit of rest. If you've done this right, you should definitely feel your glutes is working. Okay? Opposite side. So, going to turn around. From here, sign up to that horse focus. Okay, hands right under the shoulders. Check your knees. Check your hands. If you need a bit longer rest, completely fine. If you're ready to come with me, lock your hips in, breathe in, breathe out, kick. Inhale back, exhale, kick. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Keep going with the 14 more, okay? So now, if you feel a little bit more tired, just give yourself a bit of rest, but be aware. Keep drawing those tummy muscles to the belly, okay? So make sure that it's not arching, not rounding, keeping the arms nice and straight, shoulders away from the ears. Just little ones, locking the hips in, okay? So you're locking the hips in, and just little ones. Again, you might feel this side it's a bit harder, you might feel this side it's a bit easier, completely fine. Just listen to your body. Obviously, as much as it feels good, okay? Now, 20 to go? Let's do this. Bring it with you, so stay with me, okay? Little ones. Now, 10 to go, last 10. 10, with your heel.
8, not chest and your hips, 6, 1, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, hold it, now bring the knee in, to that point in the way, and then you know the deal, to the side, back, to the side, back, now again, you're not twisting the hips, really important, you're not twisting the hips too much, you just lock it in, lock it in. And again, 50 reps. 50 reps. And we've done 10 so far. So, as your body is getting tired, and this is the opposite side, so maybe it's a weaker side for you. Always listen to your body. Take the rest if you need, keep going if you can. But you should really feel that side is working. If you do feel somewhere else, it means that the technique is not necessarily there, so that's why I'm always saying mind muscle connection. As crazy as it sounds, focusing on those butts, focusing on those hips. Okay? Let's go for another 20 together. I know I like that number. 2, 4, focusing on the breathing. Breathe out, breathe in. Breathe out, breathe in. 9, 10, we got 10 more, stay with me, focus on the technique, abs, glutes, hips, breathing, arms, shoulders away from the ears, last 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, stay with me, circling, okay, doesn't matter which direction you go, just go, circling with that knee, okay, you might be feeling with this side, your actual hip arrangement is a little bit shorter, completely fine, just lock it in, if you feel the lower back, fix your tummy, draw the tummy muscles in, going to go for 2 more in this direction, nice and small ones, 2, and 1 more, opposite direction, let's finish it, last 10, 9, if your hips is clicking, completely fine, okay, once it's not painful, once it's just clicking, come on, we got 6 to go, 6, tummy muscles, glutes, last 4, stay with me, do these nice circles, lock the hips in, come on, 2 more, I might do an extra one. Last one. There you go. Good. Open up your knees. Sit back on your heels. And then release. Now we can quickly stretch it out. Okay. Just to make sure that you're going to be stretched out. So take a seat. Cross the ankles. Breathe in. Push your knees. Lift the chest. As you breathe out, start to lean forward. Once you feel your butt is about to lift up, just release, let it go. Now, just nice and easy, sink into that stretch. You should feel your glutes, bit of the lower back movement. Nice and easy, coming up. I'm going to show you from the side, okay? So you're going to unclose the legs and then cross it in the opposite way. So, from here, breathe in, pushing your knees down, lifting up the chest. Breathe out, hinge from the hips, lean forward, and then just let it rest. Now, you can obviously hold this rest a little bit longer, so you can hold like 60 to 90 seconds. I hope you enjoyed your workout. Have fun with it. Stay tuned.